Now, out of all the challenges I could have set for myself, this could potentially be one of the hardest ones. But what's going on, guys? Brandon Harding here. Hope you're having a great day. Today, we're going to be attempting something that I've never, ever done before. I haven't actually ran since I can remember, but we're going to be attempting the 6-minute mile. We're going to be running 1 mile as fast as we can. I'm trying to break the time of 6 minutes. The average time that a person can run is about 8 to 10 minutes. Setting myself the goal of 6 minutes is quite a jump, but doesn't it sound good? The 6-minute mile. I feel like that's a challenge that, like, most people try and do. Anyone that has a very good fitness level could do a 6-minute mile. Me personally, I have the fitness level that of a 400-pound whale. If you watched my previous video where I attempted F45 training for the first time, after the first 6 minutes, I was done. Completed 18 minutes in total, but did not manage to finish the 45 minute class. So today's 6-minute mile challenge is going to be very, very interesting. So sit back, relax, and enjoy this video. I haven't really put too much thought into the injury side of things in terms of, like, how easy it might be to pull a hamstring, shin splints. Anything else? I might get hit by a car because we're gonna be doing this on the street. Yeah, I could just fall over and just eat shit. Just scrape the side of my face off. You've actually had shin splints? Are they easy to get? Because I've never had them. I'm not that heavy. For anyone that doesn't know, I'm currently 230 pound, which isn't too heavy, is it? Even still, we're gonna drive around right now, find a place that has, like, a pretty flat surface, because imagine me attempting to do this completely uphill. I feel like I need to, like, give myself the best shot and find somewhere that's not gonna be too interrupted by cars, straight kind of road-ish. I don't know, I'm not gonna do uphill. What would I... Obviously, I am attempting the 6-minute mile, but I think based on my current fitness level, I would like to get under 8 minutes. How do you think this is gonna go for me?
You're gonna die. I can't do it. I can't do it in 6 minutes. I don't think.
I think you could do it.
I honestly think you'll make it through. I don't think you'll do it in 6 minutes, but probably
the belief.
I know you'll do it. What? You're fucking death.
Jordy's gonna be driving the car just in front of me while Alora sits in the boot or the trunk.
The
or
boot?
What do you say? Yeah, we call it the boot in the UK.
It's the trunk.
She's gonna be sitting in the boot. Ignore her. Ignore these Canadians. Tracking the run, seeing how I do. We're gonna be attaching, like, a little mic to me just in case I have any, you know, inspirational words, things that I feel like you should know about how I'm feeling.
Dying.
Or just, yeah, listen to me breathe my lungs out of my throat.
It's gonna be you.
We're gonna jump into Jordy's car, go to a couple locations, find out where's gonna be best to do this straight 1 mile run, and get started. We're on the way to Oakville Hospital, and we're, what's it called again? Because we're about to fucking die. We're gonna let them know previously. No. William Hamilton Parkway West. We're gonna go to the hospital first, let them know that what's about to happen, just in case we need an ambulance on call. No, but this is just, like, the location we're gonna do it.
If anything happens to you, the hospital's right there.
Oh, the clouds look so sick as right now in the sky. Such nice weather for this challenge. Yeah, this road's perfect.
Hear me? Can we put one of the seats down so that you can... We lost Brandon!
I'll keep an eye with the mirrors too, just to make sure we don't actually lose him.
Trust me, I'm not gonna be running that fast. I downloaded to track the run, the Nike Run Club app. You can set goals for yourself, so if you just want to run 1 mile, because obviously we wouldn't want to run over that, you can set that distance for yourself. It can track your heart rate, it can show you how fast you're running in miles per hour. And we did the calculation, if you want to run the mile in 8 minutes flat, you have to be running at a consistent pace of 7.5 miles an hour. And I'm pretty sure, like, Olympic sprinters reach speeds of 22 to 25 miles per hour when they actually run. So, I mean, I'm not Usain Bolt, I'm confident in my ability to run this over 8 miles an hour consistently, but we'll see. I do have the app on my phone, but I also have it on my Apple Watch as well, so I can keep track myself. My shorts don't have any pockets, they're quite tight shorts. We've got the watch to help keep track of how I'm doing. I actually got a new haircut this morning, so I'm more streamlined traveling through the wind, because, you know, I'm gonna be running that fast. It's gonna, like, slow me down if I've got a little bit too much hair on the side of my head. Also, this morning when this happened is where I'm gonna introduce you to the sponsor of this video.
Honestly, it just looks like a fucking mess.
This apartment has been transformed into many a form. Right now we're gonna, like, move the one chair and do the cut right next to the window, just so there's, like, light coming in and so he doesn't accidentally shave a massive bald patch inside of my head.
Say no, man's got the tools.
What are you prepared, brother?
Now the barber studio is also up. We've got the chair, the apron, and we got all the tools set up on the little bench thing. Let's commence into the balding. What's on the other side of inhibition? No apologies, my baby. I tell you, 'cause I'm feeling so good. cut is complete. Kevin just left. Honestly, so happy with it now. But obviously, it's been like styled and done. I want to show you how I did that and some of the products that I use currently to make it happen. If you've been following the videos for a minute now, you'll know the only products that I really use to style my hair is by this company right here. It's called Bloomon, and they specialize in hair styling products. I've literally been using these products now for the best part of over a year. So if you want to pick up any of this stuff, you can use code HARDBODY at the checkout. There's going to be a link in the description down below. But right now, we're going to wash my hair again and show you how I apply these products to myself. I'm naked. So now we're at the shower, I've got my dryer set up outside, got good light just so you can see what's going on. Right now I'm gonna like dry my hair. First product, which is their Ascend cream. This is their volumizing cream, and it actually is a heat protectant too. So you apply this to your hair while it's damp, it's gonna protect against the heat that the dryer will like emit onto the hair. So you don't like burn the ends and get like dead ends and stuff. Just one pump, get it rubbed into your hands, and then just massage it through. Cool. Alright, so now this is applied, we're gonna dry it about 50%, and then we're gonna apply the pre-styler. Now my hair is partly dried, we're gonna use this, which is their original styling Meraki. I'm gonna grab a little bit more, rub it in my fingers, apply it just a little bit, and then continue the drying process. So now the hair's dry, we're gonna pick a styling wax of choice. My favorite one out of all of these is the original Monarch. I always prefer a wax that's gonna give me a matte finish. I kind of like my hair to look when it's finished, like it doesn't have much product in it, so a matte finish is always like ideal for me. And as you can see, I've actually had this for less than a week now, and you can see how much I've actually used. Just about that much. Massage it through your fingers and then apply. Bearing in mind, I'm trying to style my hair and I can't actually see what I'm doing, so I'm like doing it by memory. All right, so now hopefully we are all done. I've been using these products now for like over a year. I won't have to like touch my hair with any products throughout the entirety of the day until obviously I shower and go through the process again. First link in the description, code HARDBODY at the checkout if you want to save yourself 10% off any of this range. I would highly recommend the Discovery Kit just because you get to test out all of the products. I also can't really style my hair anymore without the Ascend Volume Cream. It just makes the whole styling process a lot easier. I personally don't really even need to use hairspray now because it flops around, but it will stay in its place. Now my hair is styled and cut. Hopefully I'm a little bit more aerodynamic for the 1 mile in hopefully 6 minutes that I'm about to attempt to run. Now we're back in the car. We're gonna hook the mic up really quickly to my stringer vest, and then we're gonna be ready for the challenge. Nice little road mic. Hopefully it doesn't fly off in my insane speeds. I'm just mocking myself.
A little nakedness today in the shower.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, don't get too hot. I was definitely not gonna run this in a hoodie. Yeah, what do you think of my new haircut?
Looks good.
Dash.
Make you go faster.
That was the whole plan.
Like 0.5 seconds faster.
0.5 seconds in a race makes all the difference.
Perfect.
I'm just making sure it's not gonna come off.
What are you doing? Run. Because you gotta include the arms now. If you're not using your arms, you're not
I'm gonna
running.
Be using my arms, obviously, when I'm running. God, I need to save my energy for this run, shit. Oh, I'm getting out of breath. Oh, fucking hell. Any final words, Brandon? No. Let's do this. Currently almost 0.16 miles, maintaining a pace of 9.5 miles an hour. Come on, uphill. We're literally going fucking uphill right now.
Brandon is currently saying that we are going uphill, but it is not an uphill road.
What a fucking challenge. What are you doing on a Sunday? Oh, nothing. Just trying to run a mile as fast as I can. 0.3 miles, a 7 mile an hour pace. We're almost at the halfway point. 0.46 miles.
He is doing really well, actually.
This haircut is definitely not helping at all. I got a stitch and it's so hard to ignore. I got a stitch.
Come on, Brandon.
Come on, 0.84 miles. Maintaining a 7 mile an hour pace. I haven't checked the time yet, so I have no idea how well I'm doing. I don't want to see the time. run. Come on. We're done. We got time, 7:37. It's all right. I'm happy with that. I did set myself the goal of completing it in under 8 minutes. The unrealistic goal was the 6 minute mile, considering I've done this without any sort of practice. You know what? I'm happy with that, but I'm fucked. I feel red, I feel like my face is puffy. Down here, like on my knee, because I don't like run often, I got like a bit of a shooting pain down the side, but nothing too crazy. There we go. Yeah, pretty happy with that, 7.5 minutes.
Is it really attractive knowing that I can run it under 8 minutes?
Yeah.
So damn, attractive.
You're above average.
Oh, so mean to me all the time.
I'm so nice.
It's your turn.
I am quite shocked though, that it only burnt 170 calories, like something of that magnitude, with my heart pumping the way it was, the way my lungs felt like they were gonna collapse. Let's not ignore two obvious things. One, as you may have seen by the video, the whole thing pretty much was on a slight incline of at least 2.5 degrees. Number two, I ran 1.02 miles, which might have shaved off a good 5 seconds, so.
The incline was not 2.5.
Yes, okay, what was it then, like 1 degree?
Maybe like 0.5. You're so dramatic.
Look at it, it actually was though.
Quickly teleporting into the future, you know Jordy just said there was no incline? And there was no elevation. Well, just went on to the statistics on the app. There is a 266 feet of elevation gains, and there was actually 323 calories, not 170. I told you it was an incline. I told you.
What the fuck?
It's aggression.
That was a good punch.
Hey, look, guy. Oh god, snort of back. Oh my god. We just got with the Jordies. We're gonna make a pre-workout meal right now. I actually head to the gym for a workout. I'm training shoulders today. Safe to say, I'm definitely warmed up for the workout. I hope you guys enjoyed this different style of video. Let me know in the comments any future like challenges. I asked on Instagram for a bunch of video ideas, and this is the reason I actually did this video. So any more suggestions, let me know in the description down below. Yeah, with that being said, drop a like if you enjoyed it, subscribe if you're new to the channel and you wanna see more videos like this in the future, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. What's up guys? As you can see, only 1/3 of people that watch these videos actually subscribe. So I'd really appreciate it if you do enjoy this video to hit the subscribe button, turn on post notifications so you can be notified every time I post a new video, and if you're feeling generous, smash the like. I'd really appreciate it.